Folks, that's going to do it for us. We're going to wrap up this show. Willie Nelson will take you out singing the national anthem. Have a good ball game, everybody.
ABC Sports presents Burger King College Football Today, brought to you by Burger King, where you get great taste and great value every day. Get your burger's worth. Now from New York, John Saunders and Todd Blackledge.
In a moment from Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium, it's the Texas Longhorns and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. We'll get you to the game in just a moment, but first, welcome to our New York studios. And much like a soap opera, when we last left you, Todd Blackledge was picking the Texas Longhorns in this game. Some change of heart?
Well, I have changed. I'm leaning towards Notre Dame now, and really the reason I'm leaving is after watching Colorado and Michigan last week. When you look at this game, you start with the running game. Both teams like to run the football. Both are averaging well over 200 yards, but I give the edge to Notre Dame. A little more physical offensive line, and they'll get a boost by the return of Randy Kinder today, who had a big game against the Longhorns last year. Passing edge goes to Texas because they have better weapons to throw the ball to. Wide receiver Mike Adams and tight end Pat Fitzgerald, two great ones. The defense of Notre Dame looks terrific so far. Their front seven is dominating. They've only given up 46 yards rushing and 7 points. I give a slight edge in the special teams to Texas based on the performance of their two kickers. In the turnover game, Texas has forced 10 turnovers in two games. Notre Dame having a little trouble holding onto the football. Experience, Notre Dame. They're just more accustomed to playing in these big-time games. And the momentum, it's the first Irish trip to Austin since 1952. It'll be a raucous crowd. But even though they have more check marks for Texas, I go with Notre Dame. I think the physical team wins the ball game today.
I was wondering about that addition there. Now, joining us right now from Texas is Bob Greasy. He'll call the game today with Keith Jackson. Last year, Texas did not stop Notre Dame's run, but they had problems with a lot of injuries. What do they have to do to win today?
Well, John, I think Texas today, they have to stop Notre Dame's running game. That's number one. And secondly, James Brown, their quarterback, who was all-conference last year, has to be able to throw the ball. Notre Dame is going to stop their run. He has to have a big day.
Bob, is this the kind of stage and a kind of opportunity for Ron Paulus of Notre Dame, if he has a good game, to silence some of his critics?
Well, there's no question. You know, every game that Notre Dame plays is on national television in one way or the other. Ron Paulus is not a great quarterback. He is a very good quarterback. He is hampered by the Notre Dame style. But there is no doubt that he could go a long way in the eyes of a lot of people in improving his status by playing well today.
All right, Bob, thanks a lot. We'll join you and Keith in just a bit for the opening kickoff of that game.
The Fighting Irish of Notre Dame and the Longhorns of Texas. Okay.
speculation, this could be a record crowd at Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium for number 6 and number 9 Notre Dame. It's the first time the Irish have been to Austin, Texas since 1952. Hello again, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson along with Bob Greasy. Lynn Swann is on the field. Bob, the overcast weather and all of that should be a distinct help for both these football teams today. But both of them having won twice, highly regarded, are literally facing their first test.
Well, you know, they don't call them preseason games in college. They are both 2-0, but make no mistake about it, this is the start of the season for both teams. They've both made mistakes in their first game. They know where their strengths and they know where their weaknesses are. They went back, worked on them. This game will have repercussions all through the year.
It is between the tackles today where the hymn will be played.
Well, that would come from you, a big ugly guy. This guy loves the big uglies. Notre Dame wants to play the game in the trenches. They have the advantage in the offensive and defensive lines. Texas, on the other hand, has the advantage at wide receivers and the defensive back. They like to play a quicker game. Notre Dame wants to slow it down.
And Bebo is in place one more time. There's been one of these big fellas at every Texas home game since 1916.
Natural ability.
It's a lot of fun. I'll be disappointed if we don't have a great game today on both sides. I think it'll be a great game. It's great to be a part of it. That's what I told our team. That Notre Dame offense, we know they're going to try and spread the ball around and balance attack, but what they really love to do is run the ball straight up the middle. Can your defense stop that run?
Well, we're going to find out over the next 3 hours, but we're going to assign plenty of people to do it.
Coach, thank you very much. Keith?
John Makovic, who says our team, we think, is ready to step up to the next level. Notre Dame is a season maker for most every team they play. And if you can handle them, you have stepped up to the next level. That is not a myth. It's a simple fact of life in college football. Yep. They're playing on real grass this year here at the home of the Longhorns, and the kick from Sansom carries way back and deep beyond the field of play. Curtis Jackson will not return, and here's the starting quarterback for the Longhorns. They need a good day from James Brown. He's got good numbers as a starter. He's got good numbers all the way down until you get down to number 14, and that's not so good. He does have mobility, however, and you can never be sure you've got him until you got him flat of his back. So the Irish defense will be the first test of the day for the Longhorns offense. It is Ricky Williams in at the running back, and they call him Little Earl because he has been very impressive. But the first play is a pass. It's a hummer all the way to the 35 and to the 42-yard line to the senior wide receiver, Mike Adams, and the crowd comes up roaring. So a big play to start the game for the Longhorns.
I think this tells you what Texas needs to do and wants to do. They spread out three wide receivers. They started with three wide, go to their number one receiver. Adams had a tough game last year. Notre Dame wanted to stop Adams. Adams is the man who can make the big plays.
Obviously, that's a first down. Out to the 42-yard line, a pickup of 22 yards, and Brown's back to throw again. Has time, goes again down the pipe, but it's incomplete. He was getting some pressure, and the Irish did put him down as Matt Davis was the intended receiver. The Chili starting lineup now, the Texas backs and receivers. Ricky Williams has had some big games already in the two they have played. But as I said when we came on the air, this is the first test for both these teams. Pat Fitzgerald, the tight end, is a very good one. Lou Holtz has now passed all previous Notre Dame coaches in the number of games coached. Yes, he moved past Knute Rockne last week. Priest Holmes is in the backfield now, along with Ricky Williams for the Texas Longhorns on second down. It is a contact behind the line of scrimmage that slows down Holmes, and he is taken down hard on the sidelines. And again, it's great pursuit by the Irish defenders and a penalty flag. Jack Winters is the referee.
Face mask on the defense, 5-yard penalty.
inadvertent face mask. They are from the Mid-America Conference. Jack Winters, Sober, Kett, Rodehofer, Wojcis, Jackson, and Workman. The offensive front for the Texas Longhorns have got to, I guess the old cliche is, hunker down today and give their quarterback time to work. Because if they get in his face, they're going to have some trouble.
Three new starters in that offensive line for Texas, Keith.
Second down and five after the penalty. Here's a bit of a crack, but it closes rather quickly as Kenan Tatum steps in to stop Sean Mitchell. The offensive front for Texas consists of Octavius Bishop at tackle. He's a 300-pounder, and Jay Humphrey at tackle 300, but it's number 69, Dan Neal, who is the bell cow. He was an All-American last year on many people's teams, and he considered
he has 39
preseason.
39 straight starts. Dan Neal is definitely the top player in that line.
They split the backs now for third down and four. The pass underneath is good to the tight end, Fitzgerald. It'll be a first down at the Irish 45-yard line. Pat Fitzgerald, a senior from Agoura, California. The defense for Notre Dame. The big down guys, Ronaldo Wynn and Bert Berry, will come from the outside, and they come flying. Berry is a Texan from Humble. Wynn is out of Chicago. They are very good. The backers are also very good, though Corey Miner is only a sophomore. He was a starter most of last year. Ricky Williams is the single back for Texas on first down inside the 45. Passes away to the sideline. The pass is good to Mike Adams. Mike Adams curling in front of the corner. Hauled it in just right on the marker at the 34-yard line. It's another Texas first down. It is the defensive secondary for Notre Dame that's going to be tested, Bob.
This is the real question mark. Alan Rossum is the only returning starter. He intercepted a pass last year against Texas, ran it back for a touchdown, but really didn't play very well last year. But this is where the Notre Dame is going to have to hold up defensively. That's why Texas has come out throwing the football on this first drive.
They have marked off a 10-yard penalty. Here's Jack Winters.
Personal foul on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
15-yard penalty on a personal foul against the Irish. So they have been hit by an inadvertent face mask and a personal foul, and it will not please him. The ball is at the 19-yard line, and it's first down for Texas. Whistle stops them. The sun has not yet come out bright. If it comes out bright, it'll probably get up into the high 80s before the game is done. But right now, it is really very comfortable.
Yeah, I almost want to use the word pleasant, but a couple days ago, it was hot and humid.
Hands inside. There's some daylight for Williams, a 220-pound sophomore out of San Diego, and he cracks inside the 15 to the 14. That's a good solid gain of 5 yards.
All right, for Texas, the story, sweet music from James Brown. He has to have a big day, the quarterback, and force Notre Dame to throw the football. They have to be able to stop the run and force Notre Dame to go through the air.
Texas moving along, second down and five. Ricky Williams, the single back, down on the Irish 14. Possession started on the 20. Brown keeps it. He's got a convoy to that side. Now he throws into a crowd, and he's lucky to get it back.
Very well put, Keith. Good coverage downfield by Notre Dame, and if he was going to throw that ball to Davis, he should have thrown it a lot sooner.
He had help over on that side. If he'd have planted and threw from a set position, he'd have had plenty of blocking help and could have taken his time, but Ajani Saunders ran right through it and got some heat on him.
In two games inside the 20, Texas has scored 10 of 11 times. Great percentage.
Sean Mitchell is number three, and Jared Coleman is number 29. That's the lineup now, and they hand it inside to Mitchell. He explodes to the five. First and goal, and he ran right in behind Dan Neal, the right guard.
number six is Cobbins. Tatum is number two. And a huge hole opened up in the center of that line. Fee bigger the center, and Neal, number 69. Watch Mitchell. It's supposed to go way to the left. He says, hey, I don't need that left. I got a big gap here in the middle. I'm taking it.
So it's first and goal, just inside the five. Ricky Williams is the single back, has the ball. Goes to the three. And he took a real lick from Kinnon Tatum, number two. Tatum coming over the top, just really popped him and stopped his momentum.
Kinnon Tatum, the leading tackler the first two games for the Irish. Keith, I know you mentioned it before, the front seven of Notre Dame may be as good as they get in the country. Bob Davey finally getting this Notre Dame defense in the style that he likes. Young, and they can run.
Texas ought to be familiar with it because he coached over with the Aggies for a long time. Second down and goal from the three. Brown wants to throw, loops it into the corner. Dawson for the extra point. Davis will hold it. Jay Humphrey snaps it. Everything worked. And the double barrel 10 gauge blanks explode out of Smokey the Cannon, and the Longhorns have gone to a 7-0 lead.
From the other side of the field behind the defense, this is going to be a great throw. Throwing it to the outside where only Adams can get at it. It's a great drive, 10 plays, big opening drive for Texas. Plays and different things that the offense did on the opening drive.
Notre Dame special teams has always been a specialty for Lou Holtz. You can see here that they are so dangerous, and Alan Russell, to start the season against Purdue, took the opening kick off the length of the field. So you really got to know what you're doing when you're playing Notre Dame on special teams. It is Chris Spector kicking off for Texas. It is a very short kick way up the field, and the penalty flag flies as the Irish get a good return out of Ken Barry, a fullback, up across the 30-yard line. But let's check the penalty. That may move that ball back down the field a bit.
It was almost a pooch punch kick, Keith.
Maybe they didn't want Rossum.
No,
to
they don't.
Hands
Makovic
up.
Was telling me the other night that we're not going to kick it to him. We're just going to kick away from him.
Pushing the back by Notre Dame. Illegal use of the hand, so that'll move him back down the field.
Let's go back and look at the touchdown. What the quarterback sees out here are two on two by the defense. Now watch the inside man right here. Adams has got all this room to the outside to work. He knows that the outside defender is going to come to the inside. Go ahead and run it. Let's see it. Going to release upfield. Now he got all that room to the outside. He throws it way away to the outside. That's a well-designed, well-thought-out play and good execution.
The Irish come up first down at their own 16-yard line. Ron Polis at quarterback with Autry Denson and Jamie Spencer lined up behind him. And it goes to Denson. And Denson is stopped short of the line of scrimmage. I think the whistle sounded just about the time the ball was snapped, and it appears the Irish committed the mistake. So they're a bit unsettled here in the early going. So that'll back them up another 5 yards. Ron Paulus, who is the senior out of Berwick, Pennsylvania. He's been a victim in some ways.
Unfair, Keith.
Unfairly, I think, at times.
No
absolutely.
Question. No question. But that happens if you go to if you're a quarterback and you go to Notre Dame, people expect you to be great.
Yeah, the media and the lawyer faithful, I guess, just won't get off his back.
And he's been very good.
Yes,
I mean, he is, but just he hasn't been great.
It is first down. Mark Edwards is the single back now. And look looking for a little room, keeps on wiggling away, and this is a guy you like a lot. I know, Bob. He's a good, solid performer. The Chili starting lineup, Notre Dame's backs and receivers include Autry Denson. Now, Denson is a 190-pound sophomore out of Lauderhill, Florida, and he can haul it.
He can motor. Well, they took him away from the defensive backfield last year, and he hasn't gone back yet.
The tight end, Preplevich, is very good. He's a big target, 6'5", 267. But Denson right now would seemingly, he and Edwards would be the people. Second down at about 13. Wallace looks around and throws. The pass is complete to Malcolm Johnson. Johnson is taken down at the 15-yard line. Just about the line of scrimmage. And so they are looking at third and 11. The offensive front for the Irish, anchored by Rick Kaczynski, and we highlight Kaczynski because he's looking right into the face of a big old Texan named Chris Aiken.
He's got his hands full. And it all starts in the center. There's Aikens, weighs 6'1", 290 pounds, the strongest man on that Texas squad.
Third and 11. And they go to the shotgun. Double wide, bottom of your picture. Wallace's pass is thrown through the hands of Autry Denson. And here's the penalty flag, and you may have a roughing the quarterback call. Wallace was knocked down, and Jack Winters, the referee, threw it. This may be a big, big call. Yep, roughing the passer. Tyson King came in and hit him late.
Right to the left side of your screen, number 50. Unblocked.
See, King did not have his head up. He didn't know the ball was gone.
That's a close call right there. It's a big call. That's the first penalty for Texas. Notre Dame has already had four penalties in this ballgame for 35 yards.
King did not go. The ball was gone.
Well, it was a close call, but it's a big break for Notre Dame. It's like a turnover.
Chris
Aikens
comes off the field now, and number 64, Casey Hampton, goes in. He is built like a block of concrete. He weighs 317 pounds. He's 6'1". It's first down, Notre Dame, after the penalty. And they hand it off inside with Brooks, the fullback, a 239-pound, now Edwards, the fullback, 239-pound senior from Norwood, Ohio. Now here's the front seven defensively. We told you Aikens has just come off the field, but it's that nose tackle where Aikens plays is the anchor of that defensive front.
That's the key, too, to stop this running game of Notre Dame. You've got to control the center.
They ran right inside that time and picked up 5 yards. When you're getting first down and five up the middle, you're doing all right. They stay inside with it. And Benson slashes across the 40-yard line, and he is close to another first down. So the Irish get a big penalty call against Texas for roughing the passer, and they're off the hook, and now they're moving.
The defensive secondary for Texas may be the best set of defensive backs in the country. Westbrook is an All-American. The free safety, Chris Carter, is outstanding. What is it, 101 starts?
Yes.
Collectively in that group. They are a veteran group and very good.
It is the first down for the Irish. At the 41-yard line.
Lou didn't start Edwards there, who he's talking to and sending a play in with this week because he sprained his knee in a game last week and wasn't able to practice most of the week.
He's a very important fellow in the whole scheme of things, folks. Edwards and Denson in the backfield for the Irish now. That's Preplevich, the tight end. The tight end shifting over to the right side. And Wallace back to throw. Pass time and goes to Edwards on the backfield. That will be another Notre Dame first down. A very simple pass thrown to the sure hands of the fullback and put it on the Texas side. First down for the Irish at the 47.
That's the thing I like about this fullback, Edwards. He's tough, he can run the football, he can catch, and he can block.
Notre Dame trying to answer Texas' first possession, which wound up with a Horns in the end zone and leading 7-0 with 8 minutes and 41 seconds to play in the first quarter.
Lou's going through his checklist now. He first drive of the game, he liked to use a lot of different formations and a lot of movement to see what the defense is giving him, and then he reacts to what they're doing.
He's got five people up front now for the Longhorns, with Westbrook coming up on the line like he's going to blitz. And he is. And they go the other way with Dixon. He eludes the man at the line of scrimmage, keeps on pounding, and will take it down for another Notre Dame first down. So that time they get 11 yards on first down. Now Lynn Swann.
Keith, after Notre Dame's first game against Vanderbilt, Lou Holtz was very upset with the number of penalties his team had. He said the first time, blame it on the leadership, second time the soldiers. They improved dramatically in the second game, but I would have to say they gave Texas that first touchdown because of their penalties on that defensive stand. Keith?
Randy Kinder is checked in now at tailback, giving Denson some relief. Kinder would have been the starter had he not been injured, but he's healthy now. He pops in there with some authority, and once again, they've got fairly good surge off first down, about 4 yards.
It's an interesting matchup here, Keith, between Lou Holtz, who calls the plays for Notre Dame, and Gary Darnell, who calls the defenses for Texas. Guard Darnell was with Lou Holtz at Notre Dame for 2 years in 90 and 91. Talking to him the other day, he knows exactly how Lou thinks. He says he's got this list. He's going to go down the first drive or two and see what you do to the different formations, and then he's going to come back and go at your weakness.
Call it second down and 7. Well, they give him 3 yards on that first carry. Paulus gives it away to Kinder. Big hole left side on his way. And he's hauled down inside the 10 by Bryant Westbrook. This is what they will do to Texas if they can't find a way to put a thumb in the dike.
Well, from behind the offense, watch the guard. That's Rosenthal, as the ball is going to be run right up inside. Rosenthal, the right guard. And Spencer, 33, right up the middle. Double-teamed Akins.
Kinder and Edwards in the backfield. On first and goal for the Irish from the 6-yard line, and it's Kinder down to about the 2. So Notre Dame right on the front step trying to answer the opening touchdown drive by Texas. 6 minutes, 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. What was probably a record crowd at Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium. Now it's Edwards and Spencer, two fullbacks in the backfield with Edwards the deep man. He gets down to about the 1. The Longhorns hit him behind the line of scrimmage, but they couldn't hold him.
That was Akins that got through there, Keith. 96. Spencer is hurt.
Jamie Spencer, limping, will leave the field.
What a collision between Akins and the fullback, Edwards.
Denson is back now. It'll be Aubrey Denson and Mark Edwards in the backfield. It is third down and goal for the Irish, and call it the 2. Put it on the 2. Paulus loops it into the end zone. Incomplete. You know what? Edwards, leaping for the ball, probably kept Clements from catching it.
I don't know, Keith. I don't think either one of them could have had it. Let's take a watch. It's going to be play action. The fullback's going to sneak out in the flat. The right tight end is going to try to get deep to the end zone. I think he's throwing it deep to the, well, I don't know. There are two of them right there. I think he was throwing to Edwards.
Timeout call.
Good timeout.
Texas. With 5.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. 7-0, Horns lead. On ABC Sports, brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Chili's Grill and Bar, home of the Big Mouth Burgers. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. And here is the field goal try now by Jim Sensen. A 20-yard attempt out of the hold of Hunter Smith. It is up, and it is good. So Lou Holtz elects to go for the take the three.
It's a good call, Keith. And, it's a great drive. You don't want to go all the way down on the road and not get some points out of it. It was a good call.
And finishing what we started, ABC's College Football brought to you by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper butler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. So they come down, they get right on the front porch, and they can't squeeze inside the door. And the score now goes to 7-3, Texas, with 5:27 to play in the first quarter. But that's penalties played a major role in both possessions.
Yes, it did. Exactly, Keith. It turned, it was a like a turnover that kept a drive for Notre Dame going. But Notre Dame not intimidated. They got the ball stuffed down their throat on the opening drive, took it on their own 16 and just took it right back down and got a field goal. Both coaches saying, you know, what a great atmosphere. It's been a lot of hype and a lot of excitement about this game and about Notre Dame coming down to Austin. And both of them said, you know, this is what college football is all about.
It appears that young Sensen, the freshman, may have won a kicking job for the Irish. He'd been in quite a contest with Scott Sinja. So now Sensen will kick it off. First one he knocked way back into the end zone. This one is way back as well, and Curtis Jackson will not return it. So it'll come out to the 20-yard line, and there the Horns will start with their second possession. Tonight on ABC, another brand new episode of Second Noah, and then the network premiere of a police squad classic, Naked Gun 33 and a Third, The Final Insult, starring Leslie Nielsen and Priscilla Presley. It's all tonight on ABC.
Notre Dame with a nice drive, 82 yards. The only negative, they didn't finish it off with seven.
From the 20, James Brown, back to throw again on first down. Gets it down the middle to Fitzgerald, the tight end. Move the chains out to the 39. His opening play of the game was a 22-yarder on his second possession. His first down snap is a 19-yarder.
A lot of passing on first down, and the protection was there just long enough. Just long enough, he's going to be hit from the left side. I think that's Dansby that gets in there just after he released the football.
Ricky Williams going to throw it again. Coming across inside. Trying to set up a little screen action for Mike Adams. And they don't get the screen action, but they get about 5 yards on the play. Too many white shirts, not enough burnt orange in the middle of the field.
The throttle is wide open for John Makovic. We mentioned that he wants to open it up, and Notre Dame, of course, wants to control the ball with their offensive and defensive lines. Six completions already in this ballgame.
Second down and five. Ball is at the 44 of Texas. This is Williams. Ricky Williams is a load. He's a 220-pounder. He's got a first down on the Irish side of the field at the 48-yard line.
They call him Little Earl. He started as a true freshman last year. He came in from California. This kid's a walk-on, Keith, and you know. He signed a baseball contract right out of high school with the Philadelphia Phillies. And because he did that, he couldn't sign a football scholarship. But the Phillies are paying for his tuition, and he's like a walk-on on the football team.
From the 48, first down, Horn. Brown, little delay, gives the ball to Williams. Williams is grabbed by Kenan Tatum. He will lose a yard on the play. Burt Berry came in to help finish him. Monday night at 8 Eastern, Dominique Ochianu and some of her solid gold American Olympic teammates will get together for the world's best gymnasts. An hour of dazzling exhibition. It's the tour of the Olympic gymnastics champions. And you might think about getting ready for the Miami Dolphins and the Indianapolis Colts They battle it out for the lead in the AFC on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football.
We're going to find out who's for real on Monday night.
Second down, call it 12, and James Brown goes to the sideline. The pass is too high. It was intended for Curtis Jackson. Brown had it. He was available.
Well, he was available, but he had to get the ball there quickly on the line, and it was just a tad high. That's just a good play all around. Good offense and good defense.
So make it third down and 12. Scoreboard says 11, but I'll guarantee you it's 12.
Right? I believe it, Hoss.
Well, look where it is.
Well, you've been around here a while.
There's either movement or there's penetration. It might be Ronaldo Wynn. I think he might have been coming early, but now they say Jay Humphrey might have moved to draw him off. So let's see.
Dead ball. Ball start.
Yep.
On the offense.
It was the tackle on the right side. The sophomore, Jay Humphrey.
Humphrey is one of the three of the new starters in that offensive line, and if there's a... They speak highly of all three of these young kids, but they're just starting for the first time this year. A little movement in Notre Dame's front seven, and he jumped just a little bit early.
So it is third and long. Third and about 17 yards.
Here now, offensively, don't want to make a big mistake.
Brown gets it off down. At the 29-yard line, that was a great catch by Jackson.
From behind the quarterback is a little blitz. This is only a two-man route. Two-man route, only out. Man on the left running the square in. Good reaction by Jackson. That ball is thrown behind him. Look from behind the defense. The flanker on our left side was running deep. Jackson ran a square in, only a two-man route. It's a good thing they didn't drop off because there would have been no place to throw it.
Ricky Williams checks in as the single back now as the horns come up with another big play and a first down at the Texas 29. That's thrown to the sideline. It's incomplete. It was intended for Matt Davis, number 86. The story on James Brown, his coach John Makovic was telling us the other night, he has loose ligaments in his shoulder.
Well, he had shoulder problems all of last year, Keith, and he kept telling John, he said, you know, I got no problem. And John finally said, there's a problem, so they had it checked out. They discovered there was something wrong, and in the offseason, he didn't throw a football for 6 months. He stayed out of spring practice to let the ligaments in the shoulder kind of retract and tighten up, and now he has no problem.
It's second down and 10, the Irish show blitz.
Here they come.
Pick them up, the pass is away. Too high.
Now you hate to miss those. James Brown knows it.
He had him too, boy. I mean, that's touchdown. Curtis Jackson.
Well, every quarterback loves those types of situations, and that is you blitz the linebackers, and if you can block it, that means you got single coverage in the secondary with no help in the middle of the field. And he had one-on-one as you look at the blitz. Cobbins number 6, Tatum is number 2, just gets picked off. And he sees he has man coverage and just threw it. Rossum was on the coverage.
Down on the road, penalty flag on the field. Brown's got a first down, but it may come back. Line judge threw it. Against Texas, it's coming back. Illegal procedure.
What they did there, Makovic had him go on a quick count. And in the back, I think it was Mitchell, just was not set for a second. And I think that's good. You need to mix the cadence, go on quick counts and long counts.
Yeah, but that penalty just took him out of field goal
range. Oh, it was a huge penalty.
Now you know they got to throw. Corey Minor hustles back on the field as an outside linebacker, but he's quick enough to drop. Might be a tight end play right here.
Texas is 3 for 3 on third down conversions.
For the play action. Go to the sidelines. It's over there, and it is incomplete. And Rossum was the only man really that got his hands on it and couldn't hold it. And it'll be fourth down and 15.
Could have been intercepted. And I'm sure if you talk to Allen Rossum, he'll say should have been intercepted because he played it well. He dropped back off, saw it all the way, and just didn't make the catch. He's been busy, though. They've been throwing a lot of balls in that secondary.
Mark Schultes, the punter, is on. So that penalty, the illegal procedure, costs him a field goal opportunity, and Mark Schultes is in. He's pretty good at knocking the ball dead deep.
All right, Notre Dame, this, if you got any tricks in your punting game, Keith, this is a time where you might pull them out right here.
There's a global company.
Ohio State is on the way to South Bend next week. They're the next opponent for the Irish.
You talk about the tough part of the Irish schedule. They are in it this week. Ohio State next week, and then Washington comes in to South Bend.
Three pretty good sized bumps. It is 4th and 15. Mark Schultes is in the punt. Emmett Mosley and Autry Denson are deep. He may like to take a 5-yard penalty.
Texas has a great field goal kicker in Dawson.
I think he wants a 5-yard penalty. Gives him a little more room to work
with. He may not take it, though. Lou doesn't have to take it.
Doesn't have to take it.
Doesn't have to accept it.
Well, I guess they will.
You know, Lou knows how good this field goal kicker is. You know, the thing that I don't understand is if they, you know, try this and
never touched it.
He did, all they wanted was 5 yards further back to help the pooch punter get it inside the 20. They weren't trying to get him offside to get 5 yards closer for a field goal.
Yeah, he's got it nice and high, too. And he's done what he's supposed to do. Oh, they knock it down about a foot away from the goal line. Telling you, they let that ball bounce, and it was almost in the end zone. Earlier this year, we saw three Michigan kids let it bounce into the end zone.
I can't jump down here. Yeah.
You need to tell these kids that inside the 5-yard line is good enough. Inside the 5 is good enough. Now, stop it right there. Don't let it get down to the 1 or 2. Inside the 5, I'll take anytime.
My goodness. But the Irish didn't have all that good field position when they had their first possession from the 16, and now they've got to start from the 1.
Well, all that little shenanigans up around midfield paid off for Texas. By moving it back, they got great field position against Notre Dame.
Edwards is in the end zone as the single back.
Watch the screen. They like to throw screens down here, Keith.
Paulus keeps it and gets an offensive line surge out to about the 3. Down in the loveliest village of the plains tonight, the Tigers will be roaring. LSU has come to town to play Auburn. That's on live college football tonight at 7:30, only on ESPN. Put it on the 3.
Gary Darnell was saying one of the things Lou likes to do from the spread is come out of here with a wide receiver screen.
Mosley's in motion. Wallace throws it in his direction. He's got it. He was all by himself. Texas didn't even cover him. And he's got a first down. He got completely loose.
That's just a good play call and a good execution by Paulus and Mosley. You don't mind punting the ball, Keith, on this possession, but you certainly don't want to punt it from your own end zone, and you want to get it out away from your end. You may have to punt on this drive, but let's make some first downs and get away from our own end zone.
Texas leading by a score of 7-3 with 45 seconds to play in the first quarter. Ball back. All the way to Denson. Autry Denson is chased backwards down the field and is finally run out of bounds at the 19-yard line. Up to it at the 20-yard line. So that'll be a gain of about 3 yards. It'll be third down and 7.
Well, we talked about the matchup. 96 is Akins. He's double-teamed there. The center, Kaczynski, slides off and gets a piece of King, number 50. That'll be an interesting matchup all day, and I suspect that Notre Dame may be double-teaming Akins. He's like a fire plug in there, Keith. He ain't gonna move.
Give him 4 yards on the carry, make it second down and six. Wallace gives to Denson, again running in the middle. Number 85 gets a piece of him as he comes by, or is it 95? Might be 95, Mosier, Grave Mosier. That'll be a gain out across the 25. Now they move it back inside the 25, and it is third down and a yard.
Mosier had a defensive lineman's dream last week. The ball was batted up in the air. He picked off the interception. Didn't quite get it in the end zone, but he got it down to around the 2 yard line.
Time running out in the first period. This should be the last play. And they've got the first down. So after one quarter, and Austin, Texas, the home team, the Texas Longhorns, lead the visiting Fighting Irish of Notre Dame by a score of 7-3. We go to the second quarter of play now. Texas leading Notre Dame by a score of 7-3. The Irish with the first down at their own 28-yard line, and it's Randy Kinder and Joey Goodspeed in the backfield for the Irish. Wallace looking to the right side. May well have checked it. Fresh legs and Kinder. Horn stack it up. The man that's in the middle of the... the Mason in the middle doing the stacking was named Akers.
Akins.
Akins is a 290-pounder. The man who plays behind him is 317 pounds, so there's a lot of bricks and mortar in that bunch.
And they're only 6 feet one. They're fire hydrants.
They look like plugs. Look like one of those hay bales I saw Willie handling yesterday. Second down at about 10 with Denson and Edwards in the backfield now. And Mosley goes in motion for the Irish, and Paul is setting the throw, getting some heat. Gets it away, trying to get it off to the sidelines. And Kriplevich, the tight end, covered by Trey Thomas. I mentioned Willie, Willie Nelson sang the national anthem today, part of the festival that's going on this weekend, was involved last night in the tribute to Darrell Royal, as the great old coach is out there playing golf every day now. Willie, it's fun to see you. I enjoyed the show last night.
Thank you very much. I did, too. I had a good time there. It was a good day for everybody.
I know you and Darrell have traveled a lot of trails together, and I want to talk to you about it in a second. Let's see what the Irish do now on third down and nine. Ellis with a little time, but throws short of the intended receiver, Shannon Stevens, and the Irish will have to punt. I got to ask this question. How long have you had that guitar?
It's about 35 years old.
Sounds come out of that thing that nobody else in the world can make. But it looks like you've been patching it and plugging it.
Well, I've had to reinforce the insides a little bit, but I try to keep the hole big, as it, you know, because I think it helps the sound.
We've talked a lot in coaching about stability of a coaching staff. I was told last night that the youngest member of your group has been there 23 years. Is that about right?
That's right.
My goodness. That's a bunch of happy musicians right there. And good ones. Here comes Texas on a return now with Mike Allen running out of bounds at the 25-yard line. You've been long associated with Darrell, of course, and he's a great friend of the Vickers and always has been. It's been your good friend, but you've been a Texas football fan for a long time, too.
Oh, yeah, and I've come to a lot of the games. It's an exciting time, you know, and I look forward to football season.
Well, you've been part of the growth of this town, and this Austin's explosion has been remarkable.
It sure has. It's getting to be a big town.
Well, you're not quite up to the coach and I. We're a little older than you are, but we hope that you just keep on going on and on forever.
Well, I think, you know, as long as you can keep getting older, that's the whole
that's the point, isn't it?
That's the whole thing.
Here come the horns to the attack now with Sean Mitchell carrying it, and he doesn't get much out of the play. But college football is such a festival in this town.
It
I
is.
Mean, it's a happening, isn't it?
It really is. And in all over Texas football, even high school football. It's a big thing, you know.
We think we're part of the biggest crowd ever to see a football game anywhere in the state of Texas today.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So it's looks like it's a record-setting day for everything.
Great.
Well, it's fun to spend a minute with you.
Thank
you. One of our favorites.
Thank you. Nice talking to you.
Thank you.
All right.
Willie Nelson. Wonderful.
It's Derek Lewis, number 82, tight end, sophomore from New Orleans, and he picks up a first down for the Longhorns at the 38-yard line.
Nice visit with Willie. Here's your first quarter numbers. Look at the yards passing for Texas, 99. Notre Dame's getting theirs on the ground, rushing for 72. And the key stat, Texas, 3 of 4 on third down conversions, always keeps the drive going. I was going to ask Willie for a razor blade, but I knew he wouldn't have one.
He doesn't mess with things like that. Put it on the 39-yard line, and the pitch to Ricky Williams. And Williams turning the corner with a little power now, picking up about 3 yards on the play. Do you sense, Bob, that Texas may be gaining a little confidence in running the ball?
I think so, Keith, and they're doing it with their passing game. They're widening and getting the linebackers for Notre Dame thinking pass, and that's opening up some of the run. You just saw the first quarter stats. Texas had a lot of passing yardage in that first quarter.
That probably means they're going to have to get a little more support out of the secondary from the safeties, and if that happens, then the middle opens up for you. Second down. Brown gets it off. Ricky Williams catches it and shakes off a tackler and has a first down at the Irish 36-yard line. LaRon Cobbins had him cold. Corey Miner almost got round the quarterback. Cobbins had Williams, and neither one of them quite got there.
All right, take a look. Man-to-man coverage. Linebacker on fullback, and he just breaks a tackle. Cobbins should make that tackle, but Williams is tough to bring down. I really like that kid, Keith.
Well, once again, the pass is involved in a key play. Inside, this time, Williams. Well, he just ran over an Irish defender, but the Irish defender was tough enough, Ivory Covington, to knock him out of bounds. Here's 20.
Well, Keith, you're talking about the safeties having support on the run. For Notre Dame, they're going to have to get support without number 29, their starting safety, Johnny Saunders. He came out of the ball game. He has a torn ligament in his left knee, Keith. He thought he could go after the injury, went 3 plays, realized he couldn't, came over the sideline. He's got ice on it. He will not be back in the ball game.
Then that's a tough blow for Notre Dame. They only have 8 scholarship defensive backs. Now they're down to 7.
Second down and 1 for the Longhorns at the Irish 35. There's a penalty flag. They've got the yardage for the first down, but the umpire threw the flag. Almost always holding when the umpire throws the flag on the offense. That's what it is. Now here's John Saunders.
Keith, Penn State against Temple. It's a 4th and 1.
So that penalty for holding will bring them back, and it's a spot of the foul. Bring it back to just inside the 45-yard line. And Jared Coleman now checks into the lineup for the Horns. He's number 29, a junior out of Fort Worth. He's the single back. Now there's nobody back there as they throw the pass. Oh, look at this. They're going to throw it back to the quarterback, and he's got it. And it's a first down. So it's Texas that comes up with the first trick play of the day. They threw it over to Matt Davis. Davis then throws it back to Brown. It works, but there's a penalty flag down the field at the end of the play. Might come back. It will. It's against Texas. Oh, somebody was moving, or 2 people were moving, apparently.
Or somebody wasn't set long enough after they had moved. Yeah, but that just shows you the mindset of John McAvitt. What are you going to do today, John? Well, he has showed us. He is wide open, throwing it back and forth across the field.
Still second down.
He wants to know who moved, why, what happened. Must have been a good explanation.
He nods his head. The home crowd is booing, but the head coach nods his head in agreement. The ball comes back to midfield, where it is second down and 15.
Well, what that tells the defensive coordinator, Bob Davey, is, hey, guys, they'll do anything. They might do anything, so just stay alert.
Score is 7-3. Texas leads. And it's second down and 15 as they hand the ball inside for Sean Mitchell. And Sean Mitchell takes a pretty good lick, and he is turned back after the tackle by number 6, LaRon Cummins. Our college football doubleheader will continue at 3:30 Eastern today with great regional action. Boston College against Michigan. Many of you saw Michigan win one in Colorado last week. Georgia Tech will be playing number 11, North Carolina. And out west, Arizona meets Washington. So check local listings for your ABC game or games available from your cable operator. Third and 13 as Brown walks out of the shotgun and has good protection. Hits his man right on the numbers. Great pass to Mike Adams.
Keith, they're just picking up, but it all starts up front here with the protection. But watch Adams. He comes down deep, and he's just going to run a square in to the inside. Man-to-man coverage with two deep safeties. Adams does a nice job of getting inside of him, and the throw is where it needs to be.
And Ricky Williams, a single back on first down at the Irish 31-yard line. Round throwing. Gotta be a penalty as they were all over the back of Curtis Jackson. Jackson, who is 190-pounder, turned inside of Ivory Covington, 170-pounder, and Covington was all over him.
Well, they've matched up. Holtz has Covington shadowing Jackson, and his best corner, Rossum, is going with Michael Adams.
Pass interference in college football is a 15-yard penalty and a first down.
Oops, just a little early.
Ball is just inside the 20 now, where it's a first down for the Texas Longhorns. We're in the second quarter of play, 9:49 to play, and it's 7-3, Texas leading. And timeout. Whistled on the field. It's charged to Notre Dame. A lot of excitement, a lot of big plays here by Texas, Bob, but the score is still 7-3. And Notre Dame has a habit of doing that. They just hang around and let you run up and down the field and blunt you until...
Well, the concern is there's a lot of plays being run for Notre Dame defensively. They're going to have to start substituting some of those guys. They're going to have these guys healthy and ready in the fourth quarter.
They show blitz on first down. They pick it up. Passes away to the sideline. A quick bumper. And out of bounds for about an 8-yard pickup is Curtis Jackson. Now Jackson has come back from injury. And by having him over on that side, it takes a lot of pressure off Mike Adams on the other side.
Good point, Keith. Just a down and out. He was out all last year with a knee injury. Not a very good out route. He just kind of went down and bent it around. But when you got single coverage and a big cushion, that's all it takes.
And it's second down and 2. Ricky Williams. No, it's Mitchell. Sean Mitchell. Oh, look at that move. All the way to the 5. First and goal, Texas. Mitchell getting a little tired of all this little Earl business, you know. Yeah. He's not pretty good, too. I'll show you something.
He's had a hip problem the last couple of weeks and had really gotten a lot of carries. He gained over 1,000 yards last year. He's a slasher. He's not very big, only 5'10 and 195, but he's a local kid.
You put a dent in your ice cream truck, though, with runs like
right
that.
Here in Austin.
On first and goal from the 5 now. Brown gives it to Williams. And Williams will have about 2 yards. Number 13, Burt Berry. right there with him. Barry, a 6'3 senior, 245 pounds from Humble, Texas.
And they got 14 Texans on this roster for Notre Dame, and five of the defensive guys, Keith, are starters. I think you mentioned that, but Barry is an outstanding player. He's been a three-year starter for Bob Davie, and talking to Bob, he says, I got my defensive front seven where I want him. Now my defensive backs are down a little bit.
Second down and goal as Adams goes in motion, and they give the ball to Holmes, and Priest Holmes dives into the end zone. Touchdown. Bill Dawson, who's coming off knee surgery. He had a reconstruction thing on his plant leg. He's come back strong, and he will pop it at the hold of Davis, and it's good. 8:30 to go in the first half of Texas, 14-3.
69, the guard there is Dan Neal, the All-American. You follow him, most of the time there'll be a hole there.
ABC Sports brought to you by the new Dodge. We're thinking ahead. And Pert Plus, the shampoo that conditions too for simply great hair. Simply. The background is the Lyndon Baines Johnson Library, which is adjacent to the stadium here at the campus of the University of Texas. The campus at the University of Texas is a big one.
Look at the drive, 11 plays, and they took it down for a touchdown. Texas has had the ball three times, and they've had it for 10 plays, 9 plays, and then 11 plays. So they've had control of the football and the yardage.
We're talking about the size of the Texas campus. It's 357 acres, and the enrollment is closing in on 50,000. That's a lot of fun.
That's a big city.
You're right. From the 35 now, Chris Stockton will kick it off for the Horns. Emmett Mosley is the beat man for Notre Dame. 14-3. The lead with 8:30 to play in the first half. And Mosley drifting 5, 6, 7 yards deep in the end zone. Will not return it.
As we travel around, we see some outstanding players. And Dan Neal right here is going to be one of them. 69. Watch as he pulls around and leads up through the hole on the goal line. Down blocked by the tight end. The fullback kicks out. Neal blocks in the hole.
It is between the tackles where the him is played, I tell
you. Yes, it is.
Autry Denson and Mark Edwards now in the backfield behind Ron Paulus. This is Denson looking for daylight. There was none. Number 17 came over the top. Trey Thomas. Tyson King had a hold of him and slowed him, and Thomas came over the top and stuffed him cold.
Well, King is the leading tackler on this ball club, and the other leading tackler tied with him was Thomas, the two guys that were in on that tackle. Strong safety and middle linebacker.
Edwards and Denson stay in the backfield. Second down and 10. Ball is back. Passes away, has a man, and he put it where nobody could reach it but the intended receiver, Malcolm Johnson, and the play is good for a first down to the 32-yard line. Tomorrow night on ABC, Premier Sunday, an hour of all-new videos and America's funniest home videos, followed by the season premiere of Lois and Clark, and then Valerie Bertinelli and Vanessa Redgrave star in the world premiere movie Two Mothers for Zachary. Tomorrow night on ABC.
Keith, that throw right there by Paulus, he completed the pass, but it should have been up around his shoulders where he could have caught it and done something with it. As it was, he had to fall out again.
Denson to the outside. Getting a lot of help from his fullback, Mark Edwards. I mean, Edwards was like an 18-wheeler coming around the corner and leading it.
Yeah, and Detson was just like a free rider on the back of it, too. This is why Edwards, number 44, is so good. He can run the ball, but he can catch the ball, but he can also block. Now Denson says, I'm not leaving him. I'm hanging right behind 44. That's a good license number to follow. I'm holding on. I'm faster than he is, but I'm not going to pass him.
He hit the first down at the 46 for the Irish, and Kinder is in at tailback now. And he has it over the right side. Some daylight. And finally, after being hit first by Trey Thomas, is taken down by Chris Carter. But it took two solid licks to bring him down, and he picked up 7 yards.
There's a look at Akins, number 96. The Notre Dame line double teams him initially. Akers, 76, pulls out. And then a good block by Edwards, number 44, just out of the screen there, finishing off his block. Good blocking by that Notre Dame line. Experienced line, Keith.
Second down and 3. The ball is on the Texas 47. Paulus looks down the middle, throws a homer, pass complete to Klevitz, the tight end. And for the first time, Pete has one he can catch, and I mean that was a bullet.
Well, here, play quarterback for Notre Dame right here. Everybody wants to go to Notre Dame, play quarterback. Look, you can't see much, can you? Now you see 98, Skriplevich right there. Now you got to throw over all those guys. It's a good thing they didn't have their hands up. Then the quick release would have come in. Paulus has a quick release. He's got that, and he can get the ball to his receivers.
First down at the Texas 31. Changing the play. Crowd jumps in. Keeps it. Option. That is a very good way to require a little helmet painting when he gets home, because they got after him. Somebody yelled, the quarterback's got it. Boom, here comes 9.
Every time you talk about Ron Paulus with Lou, he always says, if he can stay healthy. Well, not every time, but he says that a lot. Well, you know, one of the way, and Ron says, hey, I'm healthy. I can take a hit and practice. I've done it. But you don't want to run a lot of option if you want to try and keep your quarterback healthy. And I think that's the first option that they run today. But Lou loves the option.
Second down and 5. Well, he weighs 218 pounds, 6'2", so he's pretty good size fellow. And that ball to Kinder. And he comes full bore into the right side of the line. And he is brought down just short of the 20.
But the option, Keith, is one thing that Holtz wants to continue to show to the other team defensively, because it limits some of the things that you can do.
Move the chains again on Kinder's run to the right side. He got in behind Rosenthal and Pettigrew. He's in there at right tackle for Doughty right now. Now you're going to go double wide with Nelson over there as the outside man, and Kinder, the tailback, is to the boundary side of the field.
First downs Notre Dame has run on 12 of 13 up to this point.
And they run again with Edwards. Tyson King just misses it, but coming across is number 18, Cody Danaher, to make the tackle. Chris Carter. Carter's a 207-pound senior. He's from Tyler. And of course, that's where Earl Campbell came from, the Rose City of Texas. Second down and 8. And Robert Farmer is in the backfield for the first time today.
Spread formation for Notre Dame.
Farmer's number 31. On the option, fresh leg, wide open. He's in there. Touchdown, Notre Dame.
Well, Lou's going down his checklist, and he's seeing how you play these different formations. And then he says, all right, how are you playing the formations? All right, you're doing that? I'll run the option. You can't defense that formation if I run the option.
That's one of the reasons I think they come out of the blocks next year with everybody reasonably healthy as one of the favorites to win it all, because they will have Jarius Jackson at quarterback, and he's an option quarterback.
You got that right.
He's much like Tony Rice was when he led them to a national championship. Jim Sansom is in for the extra point try. Sansom is a freshman out of Scottsdale, Arizona. And it's good. And so with 4:08 to play in the first half, it's 14-10, Texas.
Tyson King fit blitzes from pitch to the outside.
Mosley a good block. Fresh legs do help. That was Farmer's first carry.
Austin, a place that towers in the memory, transforming lives from the very beginning. Classic, timeless, always excellent, always competitive. The University of Texas at Austin, top-ranked degree programs, cutting-edge technology, a community of scholars, working to stay a dream ahead, towering in strength and pride, the University of Texas at Austin.
Welcome to the Marriott Moment, a new feature on ABC Sports College Football. Let's go to the 1970 Cotton Bowl, Notre Dame and Texas. The Horns go ahead 21-17 on Billy Dale's touchdown run and then intercept Joe Theismann to choke off the Irish comeback and win 21-17. There's Mr. Farmer who stuck it in the end zone. And Sansom now will kick it off as they go 80 yards in 9 plays.
Shows class, Keith. A team down on the road comes back. A nice long drive answers the touchdown of the home team.
And the kick. A little bit of a wind holds it up for Curtis Jackson. Jackson has room in the middle of the field and comes across the 30 to the 31.
Well, Lou Holtz couldn't have drawn up a defense better for his option. The two linebackers are going to blitz. Paulus is going to come down the line of scrimmage and option off of the in man on the line. Farmer in the game for the first play, as you mentioned. You blitz inside. A blitz you don't do against an option. Then man coverage. There's nobody to cover the man that you toss the ball to. Gary Darnell, the defensive coordinator, says, we just hope when we do blitz, they're not running the option. And it could have been a checkoff, Keith. Paulus is bright enough that he saw the blitz. He probably checked to it.
And it's first down for the Horns from the 31. Throw back inside to Mitchell. And we go to John.
Keith, coming up on Valvoline Halftime 96, I'll be joined by Todd Blackledge. We'll break down the day's scores and highlights, plus look ahead to the second half of our doubleheader. Some of you will see Michigan in their great defense against Boston College or North Carolina against Georgia Tech. It's all coming up on Valvoline Halftime 96. Keith, back to you.
How about North Carolina, huh?
Been quite good, haven't they?
Yeah.
That was a big win going into Syracuse.
Yes, it was, but they get their hands full today.
And next week.
At Florida State.
Yeah. Second down and 10. About 9.5. They clock. Did they get it off?
I don't think so. Sometimes as a quarterback, you forget about it. Both clocks are located at the ends of the field, so all the quarterback has to do is kind of look
ball,
up.
Delay on the offense.
And that's
second down.
That's on the quarterback. 98% of the time, there's a 25-second clock right through the goalpost at the end of the stadium. 98% of the time, it's the fault of the quarterback. The other 2%, it's because the play didn't get in quickly enough.
That is nearly historic, folks. It's the first time I've ever heard him say something was the fault of the quarterback.
I gotta protect my men. I told you Paulus checked off to that option, didn't I?
Second down and 15. Close again. Traffic in the middle. No place to go. So Priest Holmes, number 33, the senior out of San Antonio, is stopped right at the point of the snap. Third down and 15. The clock showing 3:30 to go in the first half. 14-10, Texas leads. Brown back. What a hurry. He's got a major league problem right now, I'll tell you, because he had Bill Wagasse and Burt Barry on his back, and Turned back inside, and Berry got him.
He had big problems. Wagasey was coming from behind, or else he could have circled back. This Notre Dame defense has played well the first two games of the year. Take a look. They lead the nation in scoring and rushing defense, and total defense are fourth. Granted, only two games, but Bob Davie likes those numbers.
That was not a very good possession for Texas.
And a very good one for Notre Dame.
Might have something to do with momentum heading toward the halftime.
Yep.
Mark Shouldis now has to step from his end zone, gets his kick away. That's a good one. Oh, my goodness, that's a good one.
Great kick. They're kicking away.
You know, way back down there at the 37-yard line.
They don't want Denson to get started. That's a good kick by Shouldis.
50 yards and no return. We mentioned the Irish schedule. This is what's in front of Texas, and I'll tell you something. They better be careful next week because they go to Charlottesville.
That trip at Virginia will not be an easy one.
Ask Florida State last year. Remember what happened up there?
George Welsh doing a great job.
So here comes Notre Dame now at 2:37 to play in the first half with Edwards and Denson double wide on a couple of wide receivers up at the top of the screen. Now this is Mosley coming towards you. And the pitch goes to the tailback, Denson. And Denson is hit. And I'll find that man's number. That man is number 96, Chris Akins.
Akins in the middle, 96, short. He's keeping Kaczynski from getting off and getting on to a linebacker. Not only did he keep Kaczynski off of a linebacker, but he finally got down the line, held on to the center, and made the play. He's a force.
And it's second down and 10 with 2 minutes to go in the first half. Again, double wide at the top, and Paulus back to throw it. Looks left, looks right, finally throws out to the fullback coming out of the backfield, who was his third choice, and it's good for 5 yards.
Good call, Keith. You're exactly right. In fact, not only the third choice, he looked all the way to the left side of the field, came back to the middle, and went back to the right side. I was talking with Dave Roberts, the offensive coordinator that works with Holtz and with Paulus, and he said this kid is not only smart, he thinks he's brilliant. He is that intelligent. He's been here 4 years, so he knows what's going on.
Third and 5. Crowd trying to help.
Blitz.
They run it. And they break the blitz, and they get the first down. Denson broke a tackle and picks up the first down.
Gary Darnell says, I blitz once, you burn me for a touchdown with an option, I'm going to come again. He's filling all the gaps, and he's doing this because he thinks he needs to stop the run, the Notre Dame run, and one of the ways you do it is by blitzing. It's run-down blitzes, or you can do slants, or you can go 5 and 6 defensive linemen.
You've got to get your hand, wrap him up when you get your hands on him. Back goes Paulus on first down from the 49, Kriklevich, the tight end. And he's knocked out of bounds at the 41 of Texas.
You saw that
close to a first down.
If you saw the graphic, that's only the second pass that Notre Dame has thrown on first down. They have 14 runs now and 2 passes.
Physical strength will be a factor in this game in the fourth quarter.
You got it right.
Minute 18 to go in the first half. Edwards, the single back, trips at the top. Wallace looking to throw it. Comes it. And it is. They're going to give him the catch. It's Nelson. Lucky Nelson. And he took it right off the grass at the 29-yard line for another first down.
Watch this. This is a fault of Ron Paulus right here. The man is open. Step up. Now throw it. Now he throws it low. He's got to dive into it. You need to get the ball higher. Quarterback with a strong arm needs to get that ball to his numbers. And he's had a couple of guys diving when they should have been open and running with the ball.
Denson is the single back. He wants to know what the snap
count is. It's a checkoff. He says, which way are you going with it? Oh, going left. Okay.
Now I'll go right. And get a first down inside the 5-yard line. Chris Dennis Carter finally dragged him down, and it's first and goal for the Irish at the three.
What happens is Paulus comes up to the line of scrimmage right here, and he says, all right, where do I want to run this play? Do I want to run him left, or do I want to run him right? So he has his keys, going to run between the linemen or away from the strong safety or whatever the key is. Paulus is smart enough that he makes all those calls at the line of scrimmage. These are some of the things that he does for the Notre Dame offense.
Right now, one would suggest to you that Mo may go to the clubhouse with the white shirts.
I think you got that right, Jeff Hardin.
Denson and Edwards in the backfield on first and goal from the three. Paulus keeps it. Rose Edwards, touchdown, Notre Dame. And the crowd got kind of quiet, except for about 5,000 down here in the corner of the stadium.
Well, watch the top, the defensive man right there. He's going to be blocked by Edwards, and then Edwards releases. This is just good film study and preparation by the coaches, because they saw there was nobody else left to cover him if he blocked him and released.
Sampson for the try. It's good. And so with 27 seconds to go in the first half, the Irish go to the lead for the first time today, 17-14.
Edwards blocks him, slow blocks him, and releases. And then Kirkpatrick, 45, is caught in between, and a nice play on both ends.
ABC Tuesday. Home improvement is taking...
All right, the Longhorns will receive the kickoff on the Irish side of the field now. Growing confidence. They've quieted a hostile crowd, and they've taken the lead at halftime.
The two guys on that completion were the two co-captains on offense, Paulus and Edwards, two leaders of this team.
Squib kick. You don't want one of those burners to get it back there. It's picked up well up the field at about the 27-yard line by Wayne McGarrity. He's got some quick himself, and he gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line, where Texas will have 22 seconds.
This drive of Notre Dame, 7 yards, 7 plays, 63 yards, came after a Texas possession that was only 3 and out.
Texas with 2 timeouts remaining. Ricky Williams, they've got 3 wideouts to the bottom of the picture. Williams there as the protector for the quarterback as they go to the shotgun after pretty people snap and penalty flags.
Now here's the situation now for Texas. They have the ball. They're going to get it on like the 40, 41-yard line. They made a mistake here.
Dead ball. Infraction on the offense.
Back
on the clock.
Texas has the ball on their own 30-yard line, but they have an outstanding field goal kicker, Keith. If they can just get across field, they have a good passing game with some good receivers, and really the weakness of that Notre Dame defense, if you have one, is in the secondary. So they probably feel like they can do some business downfield.
First and 15. Sideline panel. Oh, that's good throw.
Great throw.
I mean, that is as pinpoint as you're going to get it.
Yeah, this is good stuff. You get the quarterback outside the pocket to buy some time. You send 3 or 4 guys downfield, but this is still a hard throw. You got to throw it over. Good, number 24, in front of Rossum.
And Adams goes right up and pulls it in.
Yep. Go to your number one guy.
Put it on the 49-yard line. Make it a first down. And Phil Dawson cranking up in case he gets a call. 16 seconds to play in the half. That pass is out of bounds. That's an incomplete forward pass. Pretty good collision, too.
If it worked one side, try it the other way, and they ran it the other side. This time, Rossum got the best of it.
Matt Davis was the man he belted. Oh, you hate that if you're a receiver. Woo! You're hanging out there, that thing taking forever to get there, and you hear those hoofbeats coming.
That's when you come back and you don't talk to your quarterback for a week. You don't bring him any water or any soda or anything, you know. His receivers usually take care of the quarterbacks.
That's pass low. And Brown now misfiring. Notre Dame obviously in prevent. They've got everybody way back there. A little screen action might work here for something. But you've only got 4 seconds to go. As we come to the close of this half, and producer Bob Goodrich reminds me of a comment that was made last night. Mike Campbell told it, and Darrell Royal made it one time after an Oklahoma-Texas game as they were coming down toward the end of the half. And they went into the locker room, and here's your Hail Mary. Whoa, close. It is incomplete. The half is over. And Darrell Royal, when he was coach here, walked into the Texas Longhorns at halftime and said, men, there's a hell of a fight going out there in the Cotton Bowl. It'd be nice if some of you joined it. And that's kind of where we are right now. We score Notre Dame 17, Texas 14 at halftime in Austin.
Memorial Stadium in Austin. Texas and Notre Dame locked up in a 17-14 ball game.
It was 14-3 when Priest Holmes went over the top for this touchdown. The Longhorns at that particular point in time were pretty well in control, but here came Notre Dame right back as Robert Farmer stuck it in the end zone for the Irish to make it 14-10.
Nice call by the Notre Dame offense, and I really think that Paulus has the option to check off on that. Blitz coming, check the option.
Only carry of the half by Farmer. Now, do I go left, do I go right? I'm not sure what the play is, so Archie Denson just went out and picked up 26 yards. And set up the touchdown run that makes it 17-14, and that's where we are right now. And here's Lynn Swann.
Well, thank you, Keith. You know, I talked to Lou Holtz as he left the field, talked to him about running that option against man coverage. He said, you know, we're getting a lot of man. The option works well against them. We'll continue to do that. His biggest concerns, however, were injuries he had to a Johnny Sanders, the knee injury, Jamie Spencer, the ankle injury, and Mike Doherty, the offensive tackle. And that was his major concern. He knows that this Texas team will come back out. Now, when I talk to the Texas side, I'm telling you, Makovic was a little concerned about this running attack. He felt like they just hadn't gotten the game going. He realizes that Notre Dame is audibling when his team comes up for the blitz, so they want to change those blitzes around. They'll continue throwing the football on their offense, check their blitzes, do something very different, and he said continue to try and improve the running attack. Keith?
All right, Swanee, and here are your numbers at halftime.
Score is 17-14. Number of plays about the same. First downs about the same. Look at the rushing yards for Notre Dame, and that is key. Texas to win this game has got to slow that down. Of course, Texas getting theirs through the air, 163 yards passing. No turnovers in the game. 8 penalties in the first half for Texas. Time of possession about the same, and third down conversions. Notre Dame is not getting into as many as Texas, and Texas is making more than half of them. But the key, Keith, coming out is the Notre Dame running game. They just kind of took over from the middle of the second quarter on. They just took over. And look at these possessions. They had the ball only 4 times and not very good field position, but they scored on 3 out of 4 of their possessions, and they always had the ball for a lot of plays. That tells me that the Texas defense is not stopping that Notre Dame offense.
I still think physical strength will decide it in the fourth quarter.
Well, it's hot. Len tells us that it is humid on the field. The blessing is that it's not sunshiny, because if it was sunny, oh boy,
they would not, Booker, maybe not make it to the end of the game. Yeah. At least when I got off the airplane the other day, I wouldn't have made it.
All right, Texas will kick off. Chris Stockton will hit it with Alan Rossum, the deep man for the Irish. And they don't want him to get his hands on it where he can return it. And he's way back there in the end zone, going the other way, and there will be no return.
Nice job of kicking it away from him and over in a corner. Notre Dame leaders, Paulus, good half. 9 of 12, 86 yards and a touchdown, no turnovers. A lot of rushing. Denson had 70. Farmer had the touchdown with an 18-yard run. Edwards, the fullback, and Kraplevich, the tight end, lead in receiving. The wide receivers, Johnson had two. Mosley had one.
Well, Notre Dame comes up to the 20-yard line, first down, and Ron Paulus pitches the ball back to Autry Denson, who comes around the corner and on the very first play runs the ball for about 12 yards before Chris Carter brings him down. I want to plant this seed right now. Last year, in the middle of the third quarter, Texas led 20-19. There you see what happened as the Irish scored 5 touchdowns in the final 20 minutes and went on to win big.
This is not a short race. It's not a 100-yard dash. It is a mile, and you have to play all 4 quarters. It's not who's leading after the first quarter.
3 wideouts, bottom of the picture, and here's Edwards, a single back. Pumps it and lets it go, throwing it for Nelson, and it is incomplete. Lucky Nelson, a freshman from Harrisburg, PA.
Interesting, that's a nice call by Notre Dame. Gary Darnell, the defensive coordinator for Texas, says that Notre Dame throws more screens than anybody, and they throw them to the wide receivers. They had averaged 10 screens the last 2 games. And normally from that spread formation, Notre Dame lines up in the spread, fakes the wide receiver screen, and tries to get the man downfield. Good coverage by Texas.
Second down. Scrimmage. Akins, Chris Akins had one hand on him, but he couldn't hold him, and he turned it back upfield, and again he runs for 6 yards. Maybe more like 7, and make it 3rd down and 3.
Darnell, who was with Holtz, says he is the best big game coach he has ever seen. He makes great adjustments at halftime. He finds out what you're doing, where you're vulnerable, and comes out and attacks him in the second half.
3rd and a long 3. Paulus has a lot of time, but he can't hook up with the intended receiver, Malcolm Johnson. The coverage was from Taji Allen, number 2. And so the Irish get 1 first down, but can't turn 2, and they'll have to punt it. Hunter Smith is in. His only kick of the day so far was a 54-yarder. Mike Adams, the wide receiver, is deep for the Horns.
He's trouble there, too. He's run back a couple of punts in his career.
Notre Dame 17, Texas 14. Didn't get all of that one. Bouncing around, Adams picks it up. And he saved about 10 yards. He didn't want it, first off, but he had not called fair catch. Once the ball bounced right to him, he took it, and it'll be Texas at the 21-yard line, a 46-yard punt.
If you've got a family, this Escort's for you. Why, just think of the things a wagon can do. It can carry your gear and all of your crew. But best of all, you're ready to haul the occasional item that's 6 feet tall. You can move the troops safely, even wiggle worms.
That's good.
And you can move them all easily with what's under the hood. So if you're looking for room, there's no need to fudge it. With Escort, you'll find...
All right, Notre Dame punted on their first possession of the second half. Texas now will get the ball at the 20-yard line, just beyond it, for their first possession. And it's Sean Mitchell and Ricky Williams in the backfield. And this is Mitchell. And the senior from Austin turns it upfield for about 8 yards, close to 9.
Texas started off nicely, having the ball the first three possessions. They controlled it, scoring touchdowns two of the first three, but then the last two possessions, when Notre Dame kind of took the game over, they didn't do much with their last two possessions of the half.
Second down and one for the Horns, just short of the 30-yard line. Williams is the up back, number 11. And Brown finally recovered it. Williams was past James Brown and gone before he got him the ball, and he dropped it.
Well, this is a running play all the way. It's not a fake. He just got there too quickly.
Yep. Lucky he didn't, the way he was looking around, with Bert Berry coming, you better cover the ball.
Or maybe the quarterback opened the wrong way. Maybe he should have opened straight at him.
Could be. So the Horns make a mistake, and it's third down and 14 now. The ball is back on their own 17-yard line. And Brown, with some time, can't get it away. He's looking around, and Melvin Dansby says, enough of this. You're not going to be a spectator, and he took him down.
Dansby was out all of last year with a neck injury. In fact, he had surgery on it. And Bob Davey, the defensive coordinator, says he is really looking good in the spring. They call him the Beast. He is big and strong. And he missed a year, and he's looking forward to having a great season.
That was not a very good possession for the Longhorns. They really don't have a deep man. They had Denson back there, but there's nobody back really to receive the punt, and they let it go, and it's going to take a Texas roll, and it is going to be a prodigious number inside the 35-yard line. 57 yards. Monday night at 8 Eastern, Dominique Massiano and some of her solid gold American Olympic gymnasts teammates will get together for a tour of Olympic gymnastics champions. Dan Marino and the Miami Dolphins as they battle the Indianapolis Colts, the lead in the AFC East at stake on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. All right, it's Denson and Edwards in the backfield for the Irish now on first down.
Keith, I don't understand why they didn't have a guy back. I'm sure they wanted somebody back there. I was trying to count, see if they only had 10 players on the field.
Denson is hit behind the line of scrimmage. I was too, and I'm not sure they only had 10 out there. Loss of 2 yards. Denson is out now, and Kinder is in at the tailback position. And it's second down. That is a very long 11, more like 12. Looking around, now throws it into the crowd. Marginal. He was under duress. There's no question about that. So that's why there's no flag on it. Gary Mosier just ate him up.
It's always interesting to see who makes the best adjustments coming out of halftime, and Holtz is famous for that. But so far, Gary Darnell on the other side, the coordinator, has got the best of him. Stopped him on the first drive, and now this play, the first down, they had their first tackle for a loss of the game.
Robert Farmer's in now. Gray Mosier was the man. I called him Gary. Gray Mosier, the man who made that play, and they're out of the shotgun now with Paulus again getting pressure. This time gets rid of it, but Farmer can't handle it. He had to get rid of it in a hurry because Mosier was coming again. Pretty good piece of defensive work for the Longhorns right there.
Exactly. That graphic right there. And a lot of, because you got to consider who they've played and played anybody that's been that outstanding. But another poor throw by Paulus. It wasn't that far of throw. Should have given him a better chance to catch the ball.
Smith now for his third punt of the day. 54 and 46 on the first two. Hunter Smith. Got a good snap. Got some pressure, but he got it away. And he got a good kick in the air. High hanger. And a fair catch is called by Mike Adams back at the 27-yard line. So with 10:38 to play after a 40-yard punt, Texas gets it back trailing by three. brought to you by Ford Escort. It's new, it's nifty, made for the smart, the intelligent, thrifty. And Chili's Grill and Bar, home of the Big Mouth Burgers. Sitting by me is a gentleman, and I don't even remember the year, but Darrell Royal and I did a game together in Atlanta, Georgia, at Grant Field, and Notre Dame was playing Georgia Tech a long time ago, maybe, what, 74, 5, something like that?
It was around 74, 75. I don't remember the exact year either, Keith. It was a lot of fun, though.
You coached for 20 seasons here. You won 3 national championships, 11 conference titles, and went to 16 bowls, and your name is now on the stadium. Must be proud.
I really am proud. It's kind of hard to believe. I have to pinch myself.
Longhorns come up on first down from the 27-yard line. James Brown, a little quick to Curtis Jackson. And Jackson spinning will take it up for about an 8-yard pickup. Did you ever in your wildest imagination when you came here back in 1957 that someday they'd be talking about 100,000 seats here?
No, I did not. I knew that football might grow like it had in the past because we were having larger crowds then than we'd had 20 years ago. But it just seems to get bigger and better every year.
It's quite a festival. Second down, 1.5 yards. Inside to Ricky Williams. So the man who hit 211 for the Piedmont Boll Weevil just past summer picks up a first down for the Texas Longhorns and moved the chains.
Take a look from behind the offensive line. The center, Feebigger and Neal. 79 as Adams gets a piece right up the middle.
Put the ball at the 46-yard line. 17-14, Notre Dame leading by 3, show blitz. Don't come. And it's Williams. That's a little bit late. He gets a flag. Number 39, and the white got there late. That's Gilbo. And you've got a penalty coming up. Notre Dame hadn't changed any, have they, Darrell? They're still just tough, tough, tough.
They're very tough, and they have always, ever since I've followed Notre Dame, have had a ground assault that makes their passing game go rather than the reverse of that. They're a strong running football team every year I can remember.
He's late, the man clearly down, but once you're committed to the attack, hard to stop. The penalty moves it down to the 35-yard line with a first down for the Longhorns. Williams, the remaining back. Jackson on the boundary side looks at him and throws behind him. If Brown had waited a little bit, he might have had himself 6 because Jackson had broken free.
It was a little miscommunication there, Keith. Jackson had gone straight down the field. This is where the quarterback and the wide receiver have to be on the same page. Jackson says, I'm going to run a little out and up. And the quarterback says, hey, you're just running an out.
This is Mitchell. He broke the first tackle and the kid from Austin gets it down to the 30-yard line. So he picks up something out of it. And they'll be looking now at third down. The foot speed, the way that speed has become the emphasis of college football is startling to me, Darrell. I mean, you've got 220-pounders playing linebacker that run 4.4s.
They can fly. And this turf, Keith, is a fast turf, even though it's grass.
Third down and 5. That's Fitzgerald, the tight end. Brown back, gets a little heat, gets it away, and the pass is deflected and it is incomplete. Mike Adams was the man in the neighborhood, and the Horns are now looking at 4th down and 5. I remember one time when you had Russell Erksleben, place kicker, over here at Texas. And Tony Franklin was over at A&M, and we got a measurement on the velocity of the ball over the first meter, and that sidewinder had about 1.5 miles an hour faster ball than Russell, who was a straight-on big guy who kicked it. And these sidewinders have really taken over the kicking game.
That's the way to kick. There's no doubt about it. You know, Coach Wilkinson, let's see what happens here.
It's long enough. It's good. I mean, that thing counts from another 15 yards.
He may be the best field goal kicker in the country right there.
47 yards, and we're all even at 17 with 8:09 to play in the third quarter.
Well, for sure, he's not going to be sitting next to Paulus on the flight going home, because he says, "Hey, Ron, give it to me sooner. You're going to pitch it to me." This is a great hit by a corner who is known for his cover ability, Westbrook.
And that woke up the crowd.
That one hit could turn this whole thing around, Pete.
Denson is back. It's 3rd and 9.
Here they come.
And they've got him. Dwight Kirkpatrick was the first man to get there. We've been visiting with Coach Darrell Royal, and he just about jumped out of the booth when that last play happened. Darrell, it's always fun to see you. Bless your heart. Come play some golf with me.
Thank you, Keith. I always enjoy seeing you.
That's not a very good kick. We'll let you go on to your box and enjoy the rest of this game.
Come back to see us soon.
Thank you.
Coach, if you go that far back with my man Haas over there, we may want to talk and find some of the old stories on him. Here's a look at what the top 25 are doing today. Miami of Florida is off today. A lot of later games. Colorado's off.
LSU's at Auburn tonight. Well, that's kind of an interesting little matchup right there, too. It's Mitchell and Williams lined up in the Texas backfield now from the 28-yard line. James Brown on the run. And he's down at the 31. Brought down by Benny Gilbo. That was a big defensive series for Texas, wasn't it?
It sure was, Keith. And the reason Notre Dame has had the ball three times in the second half and has had to punt all three times.
Running at 3:45 to go into third quarter. This is Sean Mitchell. Penalty flag on the field. Mitchell breaks it big, but he may come back. I do think you may very well have a hold right along the line of scrimmage. And if so, that'll be, I think, the 9th penalty on Texas in the ball game. There it is. Remember Colorado last week? They were favored over Michigan. They had 14 penalties, including a touchdown call back.
John's wanting to know who it was. Well, that may be the left tackle. Watch here as he's going to block down on the man slanting. And watch his right arm gets hooked to the inside. Go ahead and run it. Keep running it. That flag came from behind, from like the where the referee is.
We're all tied at 17.
It's 9 penalties.
Yep, 9 penalties.
Yeah.
And the ball comes back to the 21. Where it is second down. And 16. Little play action. Bert Berry's coming. Brown gets it away. He had a man. Curtis Jackson down the middle and couldn't hit him.
Yeah, and Jackson knows it because he had him open if he could have just got the ball to him.
College football doubleheader continues 3:30. Regional action, Boston College, Michigan, Georgia Tech, North Carolina, Arizona, Washington. Check local listings for your ABC game. Or the games available from your cable operator. 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Getting down into what many of us felt would be crunch time in the ball game.
Bob Davey on the sideline.
That's Williams on a little delay. Get up the middle. Pretty good gain on the play, but not enough for the first down.
So Bob Davey on the sideline there hollering to his troops as if he didn't have enough players on the field or wanted to change the coverage. Or, you know, one of the key things that just happened in this game, Keith, is the sun has come out.
Yep.
And it looks like it's going to be out the rest, because it looks like it's going to warm up.
10 people in white shirts are up along the line of scrimmage. The outside people won't come. Nobody comes, as a matter of fact. They all feel back, and this is a wonderful kick by the Texas punter, Mark Schultes, and Autry Denson down trying to make a play. And you've got a penalty flag thrown by the linesman, thrown right at the stack. So it could be any number of things, including a face mask.
The kicking for Texas has been outstanding. The punting, the kickoffs, kicking away from the big play guys for Notre Dame, and the field goal kicking has been outstanding. Notre Dame's kickers.
Penalties against Notre Dame, illegal use of the hands, push in the back, 47-yard punt. And the Irish make another mistake, and here's Lynn Swan.
Well, Keith, in the last 5 minutes, the temperature has started to rise. It's now reached the 100-yard mark.
No,
of course, Notre
degrees.
Dame is very prepared for it. The guys, 100-degree mark. I'm looking at the field. Notre Dame is very prepared for this. They hydrated, took a lot of potassium salt. But Ron Paulus came over while I was looking at my thermometer. Looked at it. He said, hey, bring those clouds back. We need them, Keith.
You need a pith helmet down there, Swanee.
I think he's getting a little warm himself. Swanee, get some drink.
From the 11-yard line now, the Irish going to work on first down. Paulus stands up, throws it across the way, trying to set a screen, and they don't get him. He slipped away from the first would-be tackler. Emmett Mosley makes something out of nothing. And one more point from Swanee.
Well, Keith, you know, the last time Notre Dame played here was 1952, and they wore pith helmets on the sideline. They didn't have all this fancy air conditioning and cool zones and cool this, so they got in the shady side of the field and wore their pith helmets. They, by the way, won that game, Keith.
Yeah, 14-3. That was created, concocted by Moose Krause and Frank Leahy.
Yeah.
From the 23-yard line, first down. And there's the Notre Dame ground game. Just 3 yards here, 6 yards there, and they just keep grinding on you. It's a tie ball game at 17, coming up on 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Moose Krause came down in 1952 on Tuesday, and it was blistering hot down here, and he got a hold of DX Bible, the athletic director, and he kept whining and wringing his arms and moaning about the fact that Mo Frank only had 42 players, was only going to bring 37, and they had to look into the sun all afternoon. So they agreed to let them all work on the same side, and lo and behold, Notre Dame wound up with a shady corner. Won the game 14-3. Second down and 5. This is Edwards, and he's got a first down at the 35-yard line.
One of the new wrinkles for Holtz and Notre Dame this year, Keith, is check it out right here. The two wide receivers at the top of your screen and two at the bottom. Go ahead and run it. And he still runs his plays inside. I mean, he doesn't substitute. He doesn't go four wide receivers. He just lines people up and runs inside.
Texas claiming the Notre Dame man moved. So they make contact on his movement.
Offside.
They don't get the call on it.
5 yard penalty, still first down.
Texas got called for offsides, and the Texas man is arguing that the Notre Damer had picked up his hand on the line of scrimmage, along the line of scrimmage, but he didn't get the call.
We were kidding Makovic the other night about being on the sideline, how dangerous it is standing around. He's had a couple of accidents. There's an accident. He got his clavicle. He broke his knee. He had a knee surgery, and then had a shoulder, a concussion.
This is Denson. Just keeps on chucking along and gets it out to about the 45-yard line. Well, he got the concussion in the Colorado game.
Right.
Took him 3 weeks to get over.
Yeah, he got hit pretty good. And then the year before, I think, he got a knee injury. Says he doesn't look, see, like right now, he's always concentrating, look down. And if a, John, you got, when the play starts, you better better be ready to move. An old quarterback, you think he can move better than that.
Get him a tower. Could be the last play of the third quarter right here. Ball is changing it. Coming up on 15 seconds to go in the quarter. Hands it off. Last penetration by Chris Akins, was it? No, it was Tyson King that got his feet from under him. Number 50. And the third quarter ends in a 17-17 tie, and we'll be back after this message and the word from our ABC station. The final quarter is here at the Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium in Austin. 17-17 tie. Notre Dame ball, third down and one, with Denson and Edwards in the backfield. Ball is at the 45-yard line. The quarterback, Paulus, keeps it, follows the line surge, and from here it appears the spot is sufficient for the first down.
Well, we've come to the fourth quarter, Keith, and we talked early on this game about substituting heat, saving yourself for the fourth quarter, winning it at the end. This is where it all comes down to. You'll see all the players on the field. They all raise their hand, four fingers in the air. This is what it's about.
Casey Hampton is in at nose guard now, giving Akins a breathe. Chris has been pounding hard in the third quarter. They try to go right into the middle of the line where Hampton had just arrived. It doesn't work because Aaron Humphrey, a freshman out of Lubbock, is there to wrap up Mark Edwards.
Yeah, true freshman. He has been a big surprise. He's actually started this ball game. They got a lot of competition at linebacker, but they like this kid. They think he's really going to be good.
Number 18, Sakai Champion, is in at a wideout. On second and eight from the 48. Handed off to Denson, hit behind the line of scrimmage, and they stop it just a little short of where the ball was snapped. Gray Mosier, the sophomore from Bernie, made the tackle. He's been very active today. Right now, he comes off the field limping. It is third and eight for the Irish. They put Kriplevitz, the tight end, flex him out about 5 yards.
Notre Dame is 4 of 9 in third down conversions. Here they come.
Got it away. Kriplevitz is out there and can't make the play. And Paulus is on his back. And the man who hit him was Aaron Humphrey. And it'll be fourth down.
The difference in the second half has been the Texas defense making the adjustments that needed to be made and not allowing Notre Dame to keep the ball.
Irish led 17-14. Texas has tied it in the third quarter. We're now in the fourth quarter. We're still tied. And the punter is Hunter Smith. His fifth punt of the day. Ball came back to him on the ground. Not a very good kick. He shanked it. So let's see where they put it. At the 35-yard line. First down, Texas, a 17-yard punt. This, when we went to halftime, we reminded you of an old Darrell Royalism about going into the locker room at halftime in an Oklahoma game at the Cotton Bowl. That there's a hell of a good fight going on the field, boys. Y'all ought to try to get involved in it. Well, one would get the feeling that John Makovic must have done something similar because his Longhorn certainly got involved in the fight in the third quarter as they shut down Notre Dame.
Got with it.
And they take over the football at the 35-yard line. And on the carry, Ricky Williams picks up a little more than 5 yards. But we are 17-17. And I haven't seen any indication so far that either side's going to give up.
Yep. There's Cobbins. He's one of the leading tacklers. He grew up in Kansas City. He's the youngest of 8 children, Keith. And if you were looking for trouble in the neighborhood, he said you could always find it. But his mom and dad were there to keep him straight. The Big 8 schools weren't interested. Maybe it's because he didn't run at 40 very fast. He ran about 4.8.
Second down and a short 5. Brown back to throw it. Ball is tipped. And if it's not tipped, it's intercepted. Yep. But because it was tipped,
yep,
the Notre Dame man could not get to it. It was LaRon Cobbins, I thought.
Cobbins. And Bob Davey was saying the other day, he says he's good about coming in watching film. He says as long as there are some snacks around the football office, he'll be in there to watch tapes. He says he's a junk food. He says he loves pies.
Pie.
I love pie, apple pie, cherry pie. He says, I can run a 4.8 40. Doesn't matter if I weigh 250 or 220. I'm going to run a 4.8.
Third down and 5. Brown hit his tight end, Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald picks up the first down. Notre Dame claiming the ball came out. The man coming in from the side has placed it down.
It's only the second completion of the second half for James Brown. But that is a big, big effort by Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, the tight end, Keith, is almost the security blanket for James Brown. He's your tight end, and if you've got a tight end that can move around the middle and get open, I mean, you can find him a lot of times.
This is Ricky Williams. A remarkable run by Williams.
Behind the defense, number 2 is Tatum. Nice block in there. Tatum gets blocked. Neal 69 did a nice job. Fiebiger. Now he just breaking tackles. 4 is Corey Minor.
Well, coming into this game, of the yardage that Williams had picked up, and he had a lot, 160 of those yards had come after contact. So he is struck down to bring down. And Sean Mitchell now. And Texas blowing Notre Dame off the ball right now for 2 successive plays. It's just short of the 10.
The difference in the second half is the Texas running game. Cobbins is 6. Dansby is 51. They both tried to go in the same hole. Now a huge gaping hole. Keith, they may be getting tired.
Could be.
Notre Dame, that defense, those same players have been out there, most of them, the whole ball game.
They're not a deep team. Not this year. This is Williams. One. Now you know why they call him Little Earl. That's close to a first down. Texas may not only be sending a message to the country, but particularly to the membership of the Big 12. But we'll see. Ain't over.
I think Big Daddy Nebraska is sitting back there just with a wry smile on their face.
Says, probably.
Bring them on.
But the ample lady has not taken her deep breath yet. 11:15 to play in the game.
Wait a minute. I looked at Keith. What was that now? The ample lady taking a deep breath. I got to write that down and remember that.
Couple of inches short of the first down, but no more than a foot and a half from the goal line. It's William. It's touchdown. Thank you. Dawson out of Matt Davis hole. Jay Humphrey snap for the extra point. Good.
Up front, it's Humphrey and Neal and Fiebiger and Fitzgerald. And a great effort by Williams.
24-17, Texas. ABC Sports, brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust. Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. Liberty Mutual Insurance, helping people live safer, more secure lives. That's the freedom of liberty. And Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Chris Stockton to kick off for Texas. Chris is a freshman from Katy. And the deep man for the Irish is Emmett Mosley, a senior from Aurora, Colorado. Very short kick, and it's fumbled. And recovered by Notre Dame. Ken Barry, a fullback, almost lost it. We check in with John Trunner.
Keith, it's time now for the Burger King college football cut in or update.
Sure, don't they? Well, they haven't been tested either. First down for the Irish now. They trail 24-17 at 10:49 to play in the ball game. Sun is out. It's hot. Paulus pass is caught. Good catch by Emmett Mosley. The Texas man was a little late getting there, and he made a fine catch.
Here's a look at what Notre Dame has done in the second half. They've had the ball four possessions. And all four times they have had to punt the ball. Their field position has not been great. Now, if you're an offense for Notre Dame, you know what you've done in the second half. You know you're due. You know you're down by seven. Now, gut check. Let's go down and get something.
This is Denson running to the outside and then coming back into the traffic. And he's got 6 yards. Well, it'll be second down, a short four, long three, whichever you like.
Paulus has 11 completions on the day, six of them to his wide receivers.
Inside 10 minutes to play, 46-yard line of Texas.
Here they come.
Hand it inside to Edwards, the big fullback. Will move it inside the 40. Down to the Longhorn 38 and the first down. At the conclusion of the game, we'll select the Chevrolet most valuable player from each team. To date, Chevrolet awarding nearly $6 million to scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. Well, if Gary Darnell has got something up his sleeve, he better shake it. Notre Dame is building up ahead of steam.
Well, and but he has respect. You just be careful.
Paulus back. Dumps it off underneath, and it is incomplete. Somebody got a hand on it up there. Might have been Humphrey, the outside linebacker. You see big old Chris Akins. He's back in there now, rolling around in the mud and the blood, having the time of his life.
He'd have trouble getting his hand on any ball. Old Chris is only about 6 foot.
Yeah, but he's so wide, he looks taller.
You got that right. Here's a look at Paulus by half. Only 2 of 8 in the second half.
Single back is Autry Denson. Second and 10.
Here they come again.
And Denson almost ran right by him. Almost. Hadn't been for Tyson King, he might still be going.
Gary Darnell filling the gaps, filling the holes, every gap with a linebacker or a defensive lineman. Everybody's blitzing. That's one way to stop the run. These are run blitzes. Watch as the linebackers right here as they come up. They fill the gaps. Crisscrossing the defensive lineman and blitzing the linebackers, confusing the offensive line blocking scheme.
Third and 7. Robert Farmer, the single back. Crowd trying to help. Paulus wanted to go option. They ate him up. It's Wolf down.
That time, Darnell said, the heck with the option. If you run the option, we're taking the pitch man away and forcing Paulus to run the ball.
Which is the way to play the option.
Right. If you got a quarterback that doesn't want to run it. And Paulus has always said, I'm not a big fan of the option. I don't really enjoy running it.
Hunter Smith, sixth punt of the day. Last one was a 17-yarder, shanked out of bounds. Going to throw it.
Well, this is, they're looking for a penalty here. That's what they're looking for.
Throws it beyond the field of play. It was not catchable. It couldn't be a penalty.
What they were looking for was the receiver, number one, Deke Cooper, going down to draw a bumping or a jamming foul, which would be defensive interference. They didn't get it. James says, we're not punting. We got a guy back there. This is a pass. Now, we're throwing a pass. Now, if the guy out on our wide receiver jams him downfield and tries to keep him away from the ball, if the ball's in the air and he's being jammed, that's interference. Now, what the Texas guy out there on the receiver going down thinks, he thinks this is a punt, and he's blocking that guy going down. So Notre Dame was hoping to get an interference call and didn't get it.
And Texas takes over at the 36. Sean Mitchell. And can't turn the corner. Corey Minor, number four, the sophomore from La Verne, California, and Alan Rossum out there spoiled that play. And there's a loss of about 3 yards. Texas is leading 24-17. But they got to be careful.
Well, Notre Dame needs a stop here. There's 7 minutes to play in the game. They're going to get the ball another time, maybe twice, but
they need field position, too.
Exactly.
Ricky Williams. James Brown throws it under. That ball is intercepted on the ricochet by LaRon Cummins. James Brown was in trouble, tried to make something out of it, forced it. And now he has put his defense in serious trouble with the first turnover of the ball game.
LaRon Cummins led this team in interceptions last year with 5. He's a leading tackler. Well, that's a poor throw to think you can complete that pass. 1 foot down. That's the break that the Irish were looking for, and it was set up by the defense.
And they take over just inside the Texas 35-yard line where they gave it up just a moment ago. And it's Edwards and Denson in the backfield. Denson. He's a slippery fellow. Chris Carter finally makes the tackle, but again, on the first down run, he's got at least 7 yards.
Now, and this is the best field position for Notre Dame that they've had today. As you saw James Brown on the sideline with the headphones on. Sometimes you can, he's a playmaker, and sometimes you can try too hard to make a play. If there's nothing there, throw it out of bounds and come back for another play.
Well, they gave him 6 on the mark, make it 2nd down and 4. Up man Edwards. That's a first down. He's down at the Texas 21-yard line. Time permitting, Thrifty Car Rental College football postgame report. John Saunders, Tom Blackledge. Scores and highlights around the country. Both of the big games are coming up a little later. There's one out on the west tonight that's significant for a lot of folks. In fact, it's significant nationally. Nebraska is at Arizona State.
Yeah, Arizona State's got something this year.
Where do they call it? The 22-yard line is where it's marked. And they pitch it back to Denson. Good block there. Another tackle missed. And he's finally out of bounds, and he's got 8 yards.
Poor tackling right there. It all gets down, all the fancy stuff and all the formations and all the special teams and everything you talk, it all gets down to blocking and tackling. And Texas on this drive is not tackling well. Of course, Denson, they're trying to tackle him. He's kind of a shifty guy, too.
Well, this thing's turned around a bit, too. The Texas defense now may be a little winded because they were out there for a long possession. Offense gave them no rest. And they're right back out there and under siege right now. Second down, 1.5 yards. Up man, Edwards. That's a first and goal for the Irish at the 4-yard line.
Right on the sideline for the Irish, Keith. The wheels are rolling now. So we go tie this up. We'll tie it up. We're gonna tie it up and go to score the touchdown. We're down 7 points. We kick the field goal, kick the extra point to tie it up. I think you do.
Of course. Overtime rule.
Overtime, or you got a lot of time left in the regular game, over 5 minutes.
First and goal inside the 5. Pitch it to Denson. A pretty good hit there.
Denson's up over 130 yards on the day. That's 22 catches and 131 yards.
Aaron Humphrey, 46. Dusty Renfro, 46. And Humphrey, 49. Second down and goal. Gain of 0.5 yard on the play. Kinder, the deep back, they give it to Edwards up front. He's crawling around.
He's got it
over the goal line. That can't be a touchdown.
His knee wasn't down. Unless they rule his forward momentum.
Well, I'm thinking about a rule that, but he was crawling over people, so maybe he had
laying on around. Top of bodies. I always wonder how these side judge and the line on the side guys could see through all those bodies.
They
anyway.
Can't.
They can't. I mean, they
it's strictly a judgment call.
And sometimes their ruling on the fourth down may be different than it is on a first or second down.
Jamie Spencer has come back on the field with his leg wrapped. He's up there in front of Kinder. Paulus keeps it. He does not get in, I don't think. Nope, they won't give it to him. He didn't get in.
Well, I'm never a big fan of quarterback sneaks. I always felt like you got a guy right behind you that could weigh 235, 40 pounds. But now you use your best play right here. And even if you need a timeout, you take a timeout to get your best personnel and your best play in.
Martin comes back in for the goal line defense. Warfield comes out for Texas. Here comes Notre Dame now with Edwards and Spencer.
They're not going wide because Denson's not in there.
Paulus gives it to Edwards and whistle stop him, and Notre Dame might have jumped. Crowd got into it. Started roaring at that end of the field. Here's Jack Winters. False start for the Irish.
All right, take your pick. Both of the ends jump on this play. Both ends. Now, how do you figure that, Keith?
Noise.
What about the guys in the middle? They're closer, the quarterback.
Oh, no. Denson comes in now as the ball comes back outside the 5. Fourth and goal. 8 penalties for 76 yards on the Irish. Mosley in motion.
Throw it to Mosley. Nope.
Paulus pitches it out to Denson, running for the corner. Touchdown. Tyson King had a shot at him, but he couldn't do it.
You give it to your speed guy. You either throw it to Mosley or flip it back to Denson. So when it comes to crunch time, Holtz goes back to what he does best, and that is the option. 4th and 5 on the 5. We need a touchdown. Denson was not in there the play before. Now he goes in. He's rested. You run the option. You flip it wide to him, and you just hope that he can get in it.
2 minutes and 54 seconds to play in the game. Here's your extra point try by Jim Sensen. Snap is good. The kick is up, and it is good. And so with 2:54 to play, we're tied at 24. And remember, there is an overtime rule. Each team will get possession of the ball from their own 25-yard line if we get to that point. But 2:54 is a goodly bit of time remaining. Well, all of that happened back when they were fresh and the uniforms were still clean. Now everybody's grubby and grimy and getting tired and getting angry, and it is truly crunch time. 2:54 to play, a 24-24 tie. The sun is out. It's about 100 degrees. The only merciful thing right now probably is they're playing on real grass. The kickoff by Sanser goes beyond the field of play. Texas ball first down at their own 20. The two big plays in the ball game to this point. One of them was Paulus on a pitch out to Randy Kinder. Westbrook comes across and just leveled him, took him out of the ball game for a while. And then on Texas' last possession, James Brown, rather than eat the ball, tried to do something with it. And what wound up with an interception, yeah. And Notre Dame stuck it in the end zone.
Of course, he's trying to make a play, and you don't envision the ball being batted up in the air, but the receiver is not open.
You need to know when he's open and when he's not. And yeah. This is Ricky Williams, and Williams is up across the 25 to close to the 27. So they get something out of that first down call, make it second down and three. One of the important things when you ponder the Big 12 season as it has its inaugural is Nebraska and Texas do not play each other this season.
Right. They may play, though, in the championship game.
They might very well.
In St. Louis.
Ricky Williams, 16 carries, 104 yards, and a touchdown for Texas. And he's still working. Close to the 30. Depends on the mark. And the mark from the man on this side looks like it might be a first down. Close enough to stop the clock. The other thing about Texas going into the Big 12 is that all of the seats between the 30-yard lines are now sold. But as they go into the Big 12, they're following the Big 8 precedent, and all the visiting school tickets will be in the end zone instead of on the 30-yard line.
Uh-huh.
And it's called Monday. It is a first down from the 30. Brown gets a little heat and runs out of it. See, that probably is caused by what happened the last time.
Well, he wants to make a play, and he wants to make a play so badly. Like I said before, he threw that ball trying to make a play. Texas has 2 minutes. They have a great field goal kicker, probably one of the best in the country. They need to get the ball downfield. And they're in no hurry. They do not want Notre Dame to get the ball back in regulation time.
Melvin Dansky is the Notre Dame player shaken up. He's played a good ball game, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. He has been all over the lot.
Birmingham, Alabama.
You hope he'd, he missed last year. You hope it's not going to be anything serious. James Brown is 2 of 7 for 16 yards and one interception in the second half, so he is not hot.
Sean Mitchell on second down and 7 gets about 3. Yes, Phil Dawson, but he's not a factor yet. They're some ways away from him.
Both sides have 3 timeouts left.
They're looking at 3rd and 4 right now.
Yeah, and if Texas makes this first down, they'll be using those timeouts.
Time remaining, 1:15. looked up, may have wanted to change the play, but he didn't have time. So timeout is called. Saturday at 3:30 Eastern, 2:30 Central on ABC Sports. UCLA and Michigan in Ann Arbor. North Carolina and Florida State and Tallahassee. Penn State and Wisconsin and Madison and Colorado playing Texas A&M at College Station. Check your local listings for the game on your ABC station or check your cable operator. See what he's got for pay-per-view. Ricky Williams single back. Third down and four. James Brown throws it underneath and it is incomplete. The pass intended for Mike Adams, and Adams took a wicked lick as he came across.
It was Cobbins, wasn't it?
Yep, Cobbins hit him, and he's walking away very gingerly.
He's looking for some of those cookies from his man, Bob Davey, over there. Good play, good recognition.
Cobbins has made two big plays now here in his fourth quarter.
Yes, he has. Tight end trying to cross. Boom. Trying to get to Adams inside the tight end, and Cobbins dropping back in the zone just leveled him.
Now Schultes needs to deliver. With 105. No pressure. Well, he didn't get all of it. He jerked it out of bounds. So both punters have failed to deliver when they really needed it here late in the ball game. That is a 21-yard punt. And Hunter Smith had a 17-yarder a little while ago. So now here's Notre Dame with 59 seconds to play. 59 seconds. The ball is on their 43-yard line. They have three timeouts remaining. And they also have a place kicker with some leg under it.
Well, but a lot of uncertainty, Keith. Their place kicking situation has gone back and forth.
Yeah, but he can knock it. You never know. Here's Paulus putting it up. Went out of bounds. Incomplete.
Trying to hit the back down the sideline, and there was nobody there. Denson is their man. Lewis said that they have no big play players on offense, and Denson, if any, is that one guy.
Ray Mosier is the guy pestering Paulus on almost every play right now.
And if you're trying to get the ball to somebody, Denson is the guy they want to get the ball to.
Second and 10. 52 seconds. Run it up the middle with Denson. Get some daylight. And finally dragged down by Chris Carter. But it's a first down for the Irish. The clock stops at 35-yard line. First down and 44 seconds remaining.
Just get the ball to Denson. He is the only guy with speed that can make a big play.
The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game, Autry Denson for Notre Dame, Ricky Williams for Texas. Denson so far, 158 yards, 24 carries, and a touchdown. Williams, 17 carries, 107 yards, and a touchdown. Chevrolet donating $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund. Paulus back, sets up a screen, throws it underneath to his tight end in the middle, Triplevich. And they get a couple of yards out of it. And the clock is running at 20. Now they stop it. 20 seconds to play in the ball game. The ball is on the 33-yard line in possession of Notre Dame, second down and 9. Now the Irish place kickers are Jim Sanson, who's been doing all the kicking today, a freshman from Scottsdale, Arizona, and Scott Sinja, who was the kicker last year. He's a junior from Melbourne, Florida. Sinja's longest career kick, 43 yards. Sanson's long kick, a 58-yarder in 1994 in high school.
When I spoke to Lou earlier in the week, he seemed to be going back and forth between both of them. And his comment was, these kids are good kickers, great kickers in high school, but something happens to them when they come here. He says, and it's not me. He says, I stay as far away from them as I can. I said, I let everybody else do the coaching on that. He says, I don't want them to be intimidated by me, but it just seems as though it's been a long time since Notre Dame has had a really excellent field goal kicker.
Sanson is 2 out of 3 this season with a long of 33. 20 seconds to play. Wallace sets him. Second down and 9. Pumps it, lets it go. He's got a man. It's overthrown. Couldn't get the ball downfield to number 88, Bobby Brown, who is another one of the lads from Texas.
Well, it's single coverage. One of the best secondaries. He's going to stop and go. Well designed. Paulus just needs to throw it up in the air. Give him more air. You don't need to hit him perfectly for the touch. Just complete it down to the inside the 15-yard line.
14 seconds to play. 3rd and 9 from the Texas 33. Crowd coming up. 24-24 tie. Paulus pass is drilled. Caught by Malcolm Johnson. That's good for a first down, and that stops the clock with 5 ticks remaining. And it's time now for the place kicker of Lou's choice.
Yeah, that's a great throw there. Got the man open. He found him. He had time. That's the thing. He's had some time to throw. Texas in the secondary is going man coverage, and he hit that. Had good protection.
So the question is, who comes out of the huddle?
Makovic has brought this program a long way. The only regular season loss for Texas last year was at Notre Dame. Holtz's teams have always played well on the road.
It's Sensen, number 19, the freshman from Scottsdale, Arizona. Coming out, Hunter Smith is out. John Spickelmeyer is your snapper. 5 seconds remaining, a 24-24 tie in Austin, Texas. Next for Notre Dame is Ohio State, followed by Washington in South Bend. Texas goes to Virginia. 39-yard field goal try.
You make these all the time in practice.
He got it. And they'll get a penalty for celebrating. There's no time remaining, so it looks to me like they can celebrate all they want, and that's what the rule is. Time ran out as the ball sailed through the uprights, and the party is on for the Irish as they come south and win a tough one from the Longhorns of Texas, 27-24. Now looming in the background, the single biggest play perhaps was the interception, the forced throw by James Brown, the Texas quarterback, that gave the Irish the second chance at the tying touchdown. Plenty of leg and plenty of room.
Freshman. The freshman comes through.
So your final score, Notre Dame 27, Texas 24. Our college football doubleheader continues with Boston College against Michigan, Georgia Tech against North Carolina, Arizona, Washington out west. Check your local listings.